Hey mates, so in this video we are looking at the inside of a Universal Audio's Volt 2. These are inexpensive audio interfaces that Universal Audio has been putting out. They basically lack the DSP powers that a lot of UA stuff is known for. So what we're going to do is look at the inside of this unit, go over the chips that are inside, and just kind of see what runs it, how it's powered, and everything like that. So let's go. So as you can see, the board is very, very dense. There's nothing on the underside of it. All the components, all the assembly is single side. That's obviously a great money saver. And if we look at the board, it's hard to tell if there's more than one layer. If we look at some of these vias, just trying to see if I can ascertain. Yeah, it definitely looks like it might be two-sided board. Let's go ahead and zoom in on this guy. And we'll get a little bit deeper into it. I think the first thing we'll want to start off with is at the power here. Now, we did measure the power on the unit. And what we found was, of course, a plus 5-volt system. And then we found for the audio rails, it's a bipolar power supply of 6 volts. The first chip we're going to really deal with is this XMOS chip, U30870C10. This is a 32-bit 8-core microcontroller. It has a built-in USB 2.0 interface. That's a lot of what XMOS's chips are known for, is to be USB interfaces. This one has a lot of little extra features, including 33 GPIOs. Below is the data sheet and information for that in the description. Now, next to this guy, we have our, So this is going to be our flash memory. This is probably going to be the settings. And then we have a above it, this is the FT24C024. It is a EEPROM chip, most likely part of the firmware. And then, of course, we have the USB-C interface. Let's move on to probably what everyone's kind of curious about. What kind of DAC ADC are they using? And we're looking at here. Let me see if I can get it to show up a little clearer. But yep, there it is. It's a Cirrus Logic CS4272. This is a two-channel ADC and two-channel DAC. They function obviously in stereo. It's a 24-bit 192 kilohertz. It sports 114 dB or 110 signal-to-noise ratio. Not a bad chip. This chip can do internal, it can have its own crystals, but as we're going to look and see, they're providing their own crystals here. Yeah, here we go. Just angle it like this. So as you can see, we've got our own crystals for 44 and 48 in here. Next, we have these logic chips that are NAND chips, four-channel NAND chips. There's two of them. I believe this is how the function's basically being done to get the proper sample rate. So you have the crystals here and these NAND chips. This is all kind of the logic, I believe, for, you know, setting the sample rate of the unit. And let's go ahead and move on. OpAmps. Now, the primary OpAmps that you keep seeing on this unit are these OP1679s. These are quad channel QFN packages. There's 11 of these on the whole thing. You spot them quite often over and over. These little QFN packages are always going to be these OPA1679s. So here's another op amp. It's a 2122. I'm not positive that it goes to the mic pre's, because we're right next to the mic preamp, but I'm going to kind of go on in a limb and assume that. there's just one of them on here. Next to it here, since we're over near the microphone preamps, we do have this switch CMOS chip here. This is a three-channel single-pole dual toggle style switch. So I believe these function for the preamp. So it's possible they turn on and off phantom power, things like that. That's kind of what I'm leaning for, switching between line and mic and instrument level. Because it is a switch button that you send. It's not a mechanical switch that you flip. What else is there? Really, we could just kind of go around on the board real quick and just do a little tour, and I'll kind of talk through. We do have the headphones. This has a 5532, so do with that information what you will. By the way, all the chips that we're talking about, I'll have links in the descriptions for their data sheets. Well, here's the headphones amp. This is also where we start to interface with the front end. We also have the power supply here as well. There's quite a bit kind of crushed into this area. Here's our power switch. Here's our DC supply. Now, a cool thing with this unit is you can go either DC power or USB power, which can help in a lot of situations. Sometimes it can reduce noise. Sometimes it can just make things really convenient. Moving along the back, we've got our MIDI interfaces. There's, I believe, I didn't even write this one down, but I'm pretty confident we've got an optocoupler here for the MIDI isolation. And then moving here, we've got our output jacks. So as we're going over the board, you probably have noticed there is a lot of electrolytic caps in here. Now, there are a few that are SMD, but the majority of these are through-hole caps, which is kind of interesting. These caps are from Fujikon and Gemicon, at least the through-hole ones. I don't know. I couldn't figure out what brand the SMDs were. One thing you do notice is apparent is that this board is extremely, extremely well engineered. The layout, the design, the amount of components. Because you need to keep in mind, this is a lot for what this unit does. And with the amount of components that we have here, it's just quite a bit. So you get the impression immediately that this is very well designed. They've done a great job with that. Just looking at it, we got some MELF resistors there. Everyone knows how much I love my MELFs. Yeah, this thing is just a really, really nice unit. I'm very impressed with it. And that's the Volt 2 from Universal Audio, the inside of it anyways. I did some more testing on the inputs and outputs, magnitude testing, to see if there was any variance. But honestly, it was very flat, exactly what you'd expect it to be, nothing unusual. So didn't bother putting it in the video. There are more videos where we're testing audio interfaces and looking inside of different pieces of audio equipment. So definitely like and subscribe if you're into that. And I'll see you next time.